Barry, how is the week going? Has the team just been soaking up this sunshine and this atmosphere? It's taken so long to get here and you're finally here.
Yeah, what a mountain of work that has gone into it over the past, you know, 3 to 6 months. And to be here, to get it going and to be live and have our buyers up here with the borders open is a fantastic start. And obviously the results are reflecting that and some.
We just heard from Katie in that story that it was so important for the Magic Millions team to make sure this event went ahead. How important is this event for the Gold Coast?
Oh, absolutely. For Queensland and the Gold Coast, this is vital. This is the start of the year every year. This is a huge part of the events calendar up here. It's huge for tourism and obviously for the industry itself. This sets the tone for the rest of the year. This is the economic barometer for 2022 in the racing and breeding and selling industry.
Well, we had a couple of big announcements this week, which I'm sure you're very excited about. Two new races and an increase in prize money. Just talk us through the changes that we'll see next year.
Yeah, obviously a couple of new races, which will be fantastic. The Magic Millions Syndicate, $1 million race for 20 or more owners, which will be, you know, fantastic. Obviously, the syndicators are the bone and muscle of our industry. They get in behind it. They're huge supporters of Magic Millions and e-racing itself. Like, syndicators bring a lot of people into the industry here in Australia, and they're vital. And obviously, then we've also got the Magic Millions debut, which will be an awesome race. I've got a lot of trainers and owners already asking me how they're going to get their horses into it. They haven't even bought them yet. A 900-metre race for first starters worth $500,000. So the Magic Millions race series next year will be worth $12.5 million, with $11.75 million of that going off on Magic Millions race day.
I tell you what, it's a big boost for the industry because, as we know, this industry, it spans far and wide.
Exactly. I think prize money here in Australia is something extraordinary right now. It's at an all-time high, and the level of people getting into the game is great. It's fantastic, and obviously I'm thrilled that Magic Millions and Racing Queensland can keep up the standards and get the industry humming up here.
Well, of course, where you are right now, the yearling sales, they have kicked off this week. They've kicked off with a record couple of days as well. I just want to let our audience at home take a listen to this.
He's by not a single doubt the undisputed king for mine. Ladies and gentlemen, is he a seven-figure yearling? You tell me what we're. The not a single doubt Miss Admiration. What a cult. 800. James Dawson. 800,000. 800,000. Ladies and gentlemen, I tell him at the outset, with the bold opening bid, he is on the market. He is for sale. Every bit a winner. We sell, all finished, all done, to Andrew Brown at $1,700,000. What'll be eight? We sell him, can't be fairer, for $1,700,000. 1,700,000 will buy Andrew Brown. The Mar Eustace team, congratulations, two in a row. Bought a proper horse, 1.7.
So a not a single doubt colt topped today's sales for $1.7 million. You must be happy with that.
Yeah, $1.7 million. He was a quality colt by one of our most outstanding sires, and obviously they're rare now that he's not with us. So a fantastic result for Sedgenho, and obviously Kieran Maher's been very dominant in the market so far this week.
How have the last couple of days been? What's the atmosphere like there at the sales as well? Because for so long, there's just been this online environment that we've had to adapt to.
Yeah, we've been very fortunate here. We've continued to have live sales here on the Gold Coast, and this one's great to have, you know, many a person back here that wasn't here at the sale last year. It's great, and there's a good vibe around, but obviously we're doing it in a COVID-safe way and, you know, face masks and keeping people safe, social distancing. But, you know, the market itself is something extraordinary, and, you know, it's a resilient game, this racing industry.
I had to laugh in our opening package. We had Jerry Harvey saying there that you can't stuff it up there on the Gold Coast. You've got the sunshine, you've got the beach, you've got the gallop along the beach, you've got the polo, the show jumping. It's just getting bigger and bigger.
That's right. The weather's shining not brightly here right now. The sun's setting on another great day, and yeah, there's no better place to be. There's no better for a racing carnival than here on the Gold Coast. It's something that cannot be replicated anywhere else in the world. It's a yearling sale that's one of a kind.
Are you looking forward to Saturday, big race day?
Absolutely. Obviously, well over $10 million going off. The fields look fantastic. Obviously, very excited by the two-year-old races. You know, huge depth to the race. And I think it's great to see horses at all price levels running in it. So that's what Magic Millions is about, giving everyone the opportunity to live their dream.
Well, we certainly appreciate your time. It's so wonderful to see the event going ahead and being such a success. I tell you what, I have serious FOMO that I'm not there. Magic Millions Managing Director Barry Bowditch, thanks so much for your time.
No, I look forward to having you here next year. Thank you.